Hi there, welcome to the third video of this course. Today I will tell you about the creation of projects in JIRA. This is the most common and important feature because if you are using JIRA, then it is very important for you to know how to create the project in JIRA so that you can start your journey with JIRA. Let's see what is the agenda of this video. So in this video we will learn how to create project, what is the classic project and how to work with this, and how to create boards. So we will start from the first one. We will see firstly how to create projects. So let's go to the cloud instance that we have created in the last video. So this is our cloud instance that we have created. So if you haven't seen the previous video, then the link is mentioned in the description box. Please click and see that video before watching this. So in this section you can see this is the default page of a JIRA. If you want to change your default page in JIRA, then you can do this. I will explain the setting later in this course. So in this video we are going to create the project. So let's go into the project section, and you can see we haven't created any project yet, so it's showing you currently have no project. So for creating project, we will click on the create project button, and you can see it gives the options to enter your project name and to choose the template. Right now it's showing the Scrum template, but if you want to change your project template, then you can simply click on the change template and you will get the lot of options are available here. You can choose according to your requirements, the Kanban, Scrum, task tracking and the bug tracking templates and many more are available here. But as I explained in my previous videos, for this course I will use the Scrum template. So I will go with the Scrum one. I'll select the Scrum one and I will mention the project name, and the project name is Project A. Once you will click in the advanced option, you can see the key of a project. The key of a project should be very descriptive and easy to use. What is the logic behind the project key? It takes the first letter of our project name, and if you want to change the project key, then I would recommend to change it at the time of creation of the projects, because it is very difficult to change the project key later once you have created the project and adding issues or your requirements in the project. So I would recommend if you want to change your project key, then please change at the time of the creation. So we will go and click on create button. It will land you in this page where you can see the backlog options. In the backlog you can create your requirements in the form of a story, in the form of the task, and you can create the epics. I will explain you what are the epics, stories and tasks. You can see the other issues types are available: story, task, bugs, and here is the options of creating the epic. So I will explain what are these issue types later in this course. So let's see what are the options are available in this project. You can see when we created the project in JIRA, then it create automatically a board. You can say this is a PA board. If you want to create your own board, then you can click in the plus icon and you can create the board. It could be a Scrum or it could be a Kanban board. It's up to you, but for now I will cancel it. And the second option is backlog. As I told you, you can collect your requirements in the backlog. And the third one is the active sprint. Right now we don't have any sprints available here, so it will look like this. There are the three columns are available: to do, in progress and done. I will explain you how you can change these columns and how can you add more columns in this active sprint board. And there is a report options are available here. If you can see, there are a lot of reports are available: burn down charts, burn up charts, sprint reports, velocity, and the reports which are related to the issue analysis, forecast and management, and the others. Right now you can see there are the no available sprint for this board. That's why this is the reason it is not showing any report here. So once we will start our sprint, that I will explain later in this video how can you start your sprint, you will be able to see the report here. So let's back to the other one. You can see relays. This is the best option, and I love this option because with the help of this release options, you can create the versions. I'll tell you later in this course how you will create the version. You can manage your releases here. Next option is issues and filters. All issues that you will create in this project will be listed down here. So you can choose all issues and it will show you all the issues in a list. I'll show you how, because right now we don't have any issues, so we cannot see it. And you can see there are the other options are available here. You can see my open issues, my reported issues, recently viewed issues, or recently created, resolved or updated issues as well. So I'll show you once we will create issues in the project. And the next option is pages. You can show the any pages which are related to your project here. And the next one is the components. You can create the components and you can categorize your issues as per the components. This is the best feature in the Jira, and you can add the other items. Maybe if you will click on this, then you can add the repository link, pages link, or any shortcut which are frequently used. So now let's come into the last one, and which is the project setting. This option contain a lot of feature, so I will explain from start to end. So first we will start from the details. You can see you can change the project name, you can change the project key. Yes, you can change the project key here, but you are able to see this option because right now I am an admin and I have access to change this project key. But if you don't have a admin access, then you can't change it. You can mention any URL, but you cannot change the project type right now. If you want to change the project type, then you cannot do it here. For this, you have to create a new project and you have to move your all the issues on that particular project type. And here you can select an image and you can maybe put your project logo and any other related images. You can write the description. You can mention the project lead here and you can set the default assignee as well. The next option is people. In this option, you can add the people which are going to work into your project. So simply you can add the people by clicking this add options. You can choose the role and you can type the name, then it will show it into the automatically. I will explain you later how you will create the roles and how can you add the more team members so that you can add the people in your project. The third one is summary, where you will be able to see the complete summary of your project. You can see how many issue types are available in your project and what are the versions of your project's components. You can see what is workflow and what kind of workflow is using in my project's roles, permissions, screens, fields and notifications, and the other settings. I know the people who are new into Jira, they are not aware about these terms: workflow, screens, roles, permissions, notifications, etc. But I will explain later in this video what is workflow, roles and the components, permissions, and how can we manage these, and how can we manage the fields and screens. So for now, let's move into the next option, and this is the delete project option. If you want to delete your project, then you can simply click here and it will give you the two options where you can acknowledge yes, you want to delete this project. If you will click into the delete project, then it will ask you to delete the project and it will give you the warning: your project will be deleted permanently. So this includes all related issues, components, attachment and versions. No one can undo this. Deleted project data can't be recovered ever. So once you will click into the delete button, then your project will be deleted and it will ask you for the acknowledgement. So right now I don't want to delete this project. Let's move to the next one. The next one is issue types. So right now you can see there are the five issue types are available in this project: story, bug, epic, task and subtask. I'll explain later in this course what are these issue types and how can we create more issue types, because in Jira these issue types are not limited. You can create your issue types according to your business requirements. So I'll tell you. And if you don't have the admin access, then you wouldn't be able to see this action item here. So this action button here. So let's move to the issue layout, you can fix the issue layout that you want to choose what kind of issue layout should be there in your board. And you can see the information about the workflow. You can check the workflow, and if you want to add or switch the scheme, then you can do it from here. And you can see the screens, fields options and versions, components, permissions, issue security, notifications, and the issue collectors. Issue collector is a different kind of features because it gives you some kind of scripting, and that script you can use into your website. And if someone inquires something on your website, then that particular inquiry can be filled into the Jira at the kind of maybe in any issue types, maybe story, task or subtask. So this is this type of features in Jira. So as I told you, like issue security, permissions, versions, components, workflows, screens and fields, these are the best things in Jira. But if you are not the Jira admin and you are a simple user, maybe you are a developer or maybe you are a QA, BA or anything else, then I don't think so. And even there is no need to know more about the screens, fields, permissions and this issue security, because in the big organization, these things handled by a Jira admin. If these are the features are available, but in this course, I will explain these things as well, because I will cover all the admin parts as well. So now let's go to the back to the project and come to the backlog part. As I explained you about the epics and the backlogs and things, so I want to tell you about some more thing where I will tell you about the board setting and about the board creations. So if you will go into the board setting, then you can see there are the lot of options are available here. The first of all, the journal one, where you can see the board name and the board administrator. You can see if you are not the board administrator, then you wouldn't be able to do the changes in the board. So if you want to add the another one, then you can simply click here and you can type the name and you can add that particular person. And it's showing the filters, project's name, filter query, and the ranking as well. So if you will go into the column one, then as I told you, if I will go to the active sprint, and right now we don't have any active sprints, but I can show you the kind of board structures. And we can do one more thing. If I will go into the backlog one, and I can add maybe one test issue for you so that I can show you these things. So let's create a story, and this is the story one. And let's move into this. I will create a sprint and let's move into this. And then start a sprint. Here you can see the durations, start date and the end date. How can you create this sprint in the Jira? I'll explain later in this video, but this is kind of an overview. So let's start. And you can see this is the project board here. And if you will go into the PA board, then the same board will appear. So if I want to change the name of these columns, or I want to change the status, or maybe I want to add more columns, then how I will do? As I told you, from here I will go into the board setting. You can see the board setting here: journal, column, swim lanes, quick filters, card colors, layout, estimation, working days, and the issue details view. I will explain these options one by one in later in this course, where I will explain about the boards. This is how we create the project in Jira. I will tell you one more thing. So let's close these more tabs and go to the main page again. You can see the projects that you have created in Jira will be listed down here. If you want to create more, then you can go to the create project, and once you will click, it will give you the two options, the classic project and the next gen project. Jira introduced these features in mid of the 2018. So I'll explain later in this course what is the next gen project and how can we use it. And this one is the classic project, and the classic project that we have been using from the beginning, that we are using Jira. And the project A is also a classic project. So as you can see, all the power and the functionality you expect created and managed by your Jira admin. Means you cannot add the issue types, you cannot manage the workflow, you cannot manage the screens because you don't have the Jira admin access. So these type of projects are the classic projects. And in the next gen projects, you can configure lot of things by yourself. There is no need of the Jira admin, but I'll explain you what are the next gen projects later in this video. And this is really a very interesting features that the Jira introduced nowadays, and it is only available in the cloud one. So if you are using a server instance, then you wouldn't be able to use these features and you wouldn't able to see that particular options at the time of creating the project. So that's all for today. I hope you guys like understand how to create the project and how can you check the different options, like how can you see the permission schemas, issues, details and the summary of the projects. So if you have any query, then please feel free to ask in the comment box. I will be happy to give you the answers of your queries. So please be in touch and we will learn more about the next gen projects in the next video. Thanks for watching. Thank you.